Okay, so this page of your notes is on types of white blood cells. I'm going to split them into three main kinds. Before I do that, I'll give you a general term for white blood cells, which is leukocytes. And that word literally means white cells. Leukocytes. And let's use a blue pen. The first category of white blood cells that I'm going to talk about are granulocytes. And like the name sounds, they have granules containing chemicals that help you defend yourself from pathogenic invaders. And then the second class, I'll use a green pen, are lymphocytes. Lymphocytes, you can kind of hear in their name that they commonly reside in lymphatic tissue, such as lymph nodes. And they mature often in lymphatic tissue as well. And then the third way that I'm going to break apart white blood cells is a group called antigen-presenting cells. Can you see that? Antigen-presenting cells, or APCs. And like their name sounds, they are going to present antigens, or little pieces from cells and things that they run into, to other white blood cells to see if we should attack or not. Okay, let's go back up to the top then and look at the granulocytes. So the first kind of granulocyte is very common in your bloodstream, maybe as many as 70% of the white blood cells circulating at any given time may be this kind of cell, which is a neutrophil. Something that's kind of notable about it is that it is neutral loving. That's what that stands for. And essentially that means when you put a white stain on a blood sample, this kind of granulocyte won't take up acidic dyes very well. It won't take up basic dyes very well. So it just doesn't stain very well in general. And it does have granules, but you can't see them very well. And then, as I already mentioned, this is the most common type of white blood cell that you'll find in the bloodstream. These are very phagocytic. What that means, phago means eat, and cyte means cell. And so they can kill a whole variety of different kinds of pathogens. They're sort of the jack of all trades. If you were cleaning your house, this would be the go-to cleaner. And they're able to secrete peroxide. Sorry, my arrow. They secrete peroxide and bleach. So the analogy of household cleaning is not that far off. Okay, then a very, very rare kind of white blood cell that we find in the bloodstream is called a basophil. Now, we'll still make the nucleus, which is bilobed, make that blue, but then use a purple pen to write basophil here. And these are basic loving. So when white stain is put on a blood sample, these cells, their granules will stain purple. So much so, in fact, that the edges will often look a little bumpy on these cells, and they might just look purely purple. It's just all you can see are those purple granules. And these granules secrete histamine. And that is going to cause leaky capillaries. In other words, inflammation. These are the rarest circulating in the blood. However, they have a counterpart that's found in the tissues, and that's called a mast cell. And I'd like to mention it here because even though these don't circulate in the blood, they are definitely a type of mast cell, or sorry, a type of white blood cell, and they play a really important role in allergies. So if you have a lot of activated mast cells in the mucous membranes of your respiratory tract or your GI tract, then those are the release of histamine can be associated with the symptoms that you have from that allergy. So we can color this blood vessel pink. And water will come out of the blood vessels more freely when histamine is around, and then that causes inflammation, which can be important in fighting infection. It can be problematic in allergies. Okay, now the next white blood cell. Let's go ahead and make another bilobed nucleus. Notice that these cells have very similar nucleus. They originate similarly in the bone marrow and then differentiate, though, into either an eosinophil, this one with pink, or basophil. Now these ones, if you dump a bunch of right stain on this kind of a blood sample, these kinds of cells will look pink or red because they are acid-loving. And so most acidic dyes tend to be pink. And so they stain pink. Sometimes they look red. These are also very rare. You don't find a lot of them. They also secrete histamine and also peroxides, kind of a variety of ingredients in their granules. And these granules are, let's use a yellow highlighter here, are very good at fighting off eukaryotic pathogens, especially helminths. So they tend to inhibit parasites, such as parasitic worms. Okay, so that is a real quick overview of the different kinds of granulocytes. So granulocytes, once again, are found in circulating in the bloodstream and in tissues. Neutrophils, their granules don't stain very well. Basophils, their granules stain purple. And eosinophils, their granules stain pink. And then I'll pick up for the next type of white blood cell in the next video.